to a seated position. We'll start to lengthen the spine. Feel the shoulders, the tailbone relax. Find some long, deep breaths from the nose towards the belly. Resting our breath out of the belly, out of the nose. Help our spine grow taller as we inhale. Our shoulders, hips rest as we exhale. Breathe. Listen an ear to the shoulder, letting the side of the neck stretch open. Reaching tall, relaxing towards the other side. Reaching tall, let's slide the shoulder blades up and down. Inhaling, thumbs to the heart. Inhaling as we lengthen. Exhaling lower. Finding one more breath. Let's inhale, reach up tall. And exhale down. Relaxing the hands, let's find a deep breath. Inhale, lungs up to the sky. Exhaling, hinging softly forward. Or a little deeper, depending on how our hips, our spine, our shoulders, ribs feel today. Let's find a few resting breaths as we relax through our exhale. Letting the inhale send our spine back tall, shoulders relax. Let's inhale, fingertips towards the sky, and then exhale, twist to the side. Lift back to the center, inhale, lifting tall. Exhaling, thumbs to the heart. So from here, wherever our crisscross is, we can trade it out. We have symmetrical legs, we can keep both symmetrical. Let our inhale pick up the ribs on the inhale, and then exhale, maybe a little bit, maybe a little bit more, get a little release as we breathe. Lifting our spine, butt tall. We're going to stretch our bodies into an all fours position, pulling the wrist under the shoulders, the knees under the hips, feeling that tall spine. We'll begin to inhale the heart forward, finding our cow pose, exhaling the ribs towards the sky, finding our cat pose. We'll get just a little flowing movement through the spine as we breathe, expanding, relaxing into our breath. We're welcome to continue this flowing movement up and down as we find a neutral spine. Add that side to side, shoulders towards the hips on one side, shoulders towards the hips on the other side. A little flowing movement through our spine. As we find neutral, lower body comes in. We're sending the right knee out to the side and circling the knee. Trade the direction of the circle. And with our thigh lifted, we'll pull the thigh back, pull the knee towards the shoulder. You can stay with the knee bent, or as the knee comes towards the shoulder, start stretching the leg towards straight, and bend the knee to send it back, lengthening the leg towards straight, just a little bit of reach. Heel. Then we'll relax that knee. Let's trade legs. Start to let the left knee circle. Feel a little movement in the hip. Maybe trade out that direction. With our knee lifted, we're pulling the heel towards the hip. Drawing our knee towards the shoulder, tying that reach, release through the side of the shoulder. Begin to push the heel towards straight, and then the knee to slide it back. Just a little reach, release here with our breath. We'll end up releasing here, resting back to child's pose, finding relaxation through our shoulders. Lifts or lower back. Finding stillness or pulling the arms to the left, opening up the side body. And over towards the other side. As we return to neutral, resting the shoulders in stillness, continuing with child's pose or reaching up to downward dog. With our spine tall, our legs can be bent or straight or move the legs, one thigh pressing forward, the other thigh pressing back. Sending feet up towards the hands, creating rest in our forward fold. Maybe our head and neck relax in stillness, or find a little bit of movement up and down. Maybe a little bit of movement side to side. Maybe a little movement up and down again. With our inhale, stretching up halfway, feel that length through our spine. Planting the heel, let's inhale, lift up all the way, heart towards the sky. Stretching one arm up to the sky, one arm towards the ground, with the fingers pull in opposite directions. Now we'll trade, the other arm up to the sky, the other arm to the ground. And then we'll send both arms up, lifting the lungs. Exhale, swan diving down. Pulling the right knee behind us, sink, inhale, pull the hips and heart forward. Exhaling, relaxing, hips and thighs back. Hanging out either option or adding that flow with our inhales, sending us in towards our lunge. Our exhales, relaxing us in to our half pyramid, and we're finding that reach, that relaxation through our hips and thighs as we breathe. Keep the movement flowing. Maybe we find a place of stillness. Continuing with a tall spine, maybe heart relaxes towards the thighs, and breathe. Going in the inhale, stretch our hips and heart forward, then we're exhaling, resting back. Find a place of rest or movement option to inhale through plank or kneeling plank, stabilizing the spine. Staying or exhaling, elbows into the ribs, allowing the hips to relax and the heart to open the cobra. Pulling through that lower belly to find rest back. Into our child's pose, find a moment to breathe. Helping the right toes find their way into our lunge, heel resting under the knee. Feeling the hips and the heart flow forward into our lunge. Our exhale relaxes our hips and thighs to the head pyramid. Staying in either option or flowing with our breath, guiding our bodies forward and back. So relax, rest. Finding release as we breathe. Keeping the movement flowing or finding a place of stillness just for a moment. Keeping a tall spine or finding a little bit more release of the heart towards the thigh. Feeling the inhale, drawing our hips and heart forward. Head and neck to find that flowing movement up and down. Maybe we're flowing a bit side to side. Maybe a little up and down again. Let's inhale, stretch up halfway. Pushing through the heels. We're inhaling, lifting up all the way heart to the sky. And exhale, relaxing palms to the heart. With our inhale, reaching the arms tall. With our exhale, sending one arm forward, the other arm back. Inhaling as we lengthen, exhaling, rotate to the other side. Reaching and rotating as we relax through our breath. Finding a little evenness in our movement. And inhale, lift the heart towards the sky. Exhaling, tailbone back to chair. Get a cup of warmth. Inhale, lift the lungs. Exhaling, chair. Inhale, lift the lungs. We're going to stay in our chair. Reaching the tailbone through the top of the head, through the fingertips, exhaling, elbows to the ribs, inhaling, arms tall. Feel a little movement as we breathe. And relaxing the palms on the thighs, big breath, inhales the heart forward, standing cow, exhaling, fold the ribs in, standing cat, relaxing in our forward fold, sending the left toes behind us into our lunge. Back knee lifted or lowered, let's twist towards the front thigh and lift the chest. Relaxing down, reaching back, child's pose or downward dog. Enjoying a moment of stillness, options for movement, inhaling through plank or kneeling plank to stay. Maybe exhaling with control elbows towards the ribs, inhaling, expanding through the front side body, and then exhaling, resting back. Find a moment to breathe. Helping our left toes stretch their way into our lunge. Sending the body into the twist towards the front back. Releasing back. Child's pose or downward dog. Find a moment to breathe. We will stretch for our breath. And then from either an all fours position or downward dog, we're sending the right toes up to the sky or out from the hip. And we're going to pull the right knee towards the right shoulder, stretch it back up or out. Right knee towards the right shoulder, stretch back out. Do one more. Knee towards the shoulder. As our leg reaches out, maybe the heel reaches back towards the hip. Take a moment to breathe. Then we'll send the right foot into our lunge, opening into a warrior two. Lifting the chest over our hips, fingers reaching towards our feet. So as we relax our hands on our hips, we're going to take a moment with this front thigh. So as our knee is bent, we're going to feel the body roll towards the pinky toe, roll towards the mid toe. Feel the movement happening as much as possible from the thighs. If we're feeling uncomfortable in the ankle or the knee, feeling free to stop. Just get a little rolling movement. Over the heel. Hand can stay on the thigh, maybe the elbow rests to the thigh as we reach through the back of the head, through the back of the hips, opening through the heart, breathe. Feel that stretch through our spine. Now we're going to stretch our front leg towards straight, and then feel your outer hip pull that knee back towards the toe. Just a little bit of movement. Squeezing that front leg towards straight. Pressing that inner thigh back out. And feel just a little stretch here as we breathe. Now with the knee bent, both hands rest on the front thigh, picking up the back heel, maybe resting the back knee, our body's choice, as we breathe. We're going to reach the fingertips towards the sky in our lunge. Squeezing everything towards the midline of the body. We're going to rest. Fingertips to the ground. Send the front foot back where you feel comfortable. Downward dog, kneeling dog. Child's pose on all fours. Take a moment to breathe. And as we find a place of rest and relaxation, enjoying stillness, maybe inhaling through plank or kneeling plank. Maybe we're exhaling, elbows in, inhaling the heart open, exhaling the hips back and relax. Through our breath, just a moment to breathe, working for this stretch today. And then again, from either our all fours or our downward dog, the left leg reaches out from the hip. It can stay, or the left knee reaches towards the shoulder stretches back. Left knee towards the shoulder, stretching back. And then maybe bending the knee so the heel reaches towards the hip. Take a moment to breathe. Helping the left hip find its way into our lunge. Planting our back heel as we open to warrior two. Drawing our arms towards our feet. Shoulders stacking over the hips. Kicking in the thighs. Take a moment to breathe. Now we're going to relax, hands on the thighs, and then maybe moving the front leg, rolling towards the big toe, rolling towards the pinky toe, feel the thigh and the hips, creating the movement. It doesn't have to be very big, it's wherever your joints feel still stable, the movement as we breathe. Now we'll find a place to ground the foot, feel maybe the knee has this length through the spine, through the back heel, through the hip, feel that openness through our breath. Now we're welcome to just continue. Maybe we squeeze the inner thigh, pulling the front leg towards straight. Maybe we squeeze the outer hip, drawing the knee back towards the heel. Feeling that reach and release, activating through that thigh and that hip to feel the strength through our breath. And with our knee bent, both hands rest on the front thigh. Option to stay as we are, maybe we squeeze the inner thighs and pick up the back heel, finding our lunge with the palms on the thighs or fingertips towards the sky, finding length and strength as we breathe. And then returning, hands towards the ground. Option to child's pose, downward dog, maybe the all fours or a three-legged dog option and breathe. Finding a moment of rest, enjoying stillness, options for a plank, or new incline to hang out. Maybe we're exhaling, elbows in, inhaling heart open, exhaling hips back, and breathe. Option for that three-legged dog with the right heel reaching up to the sky or heel reaching towards the hip, opening the front of the thigh. We're sending the right foot wide outside our right hand. Back knee can be up or down. Finding a little flowing movement, pushing the hips back, pulling the hips forward. Trying to activate any range of motion, any pace of movement as we breathe here. Feeling the strength through the legs, through the torso as we breathe. So we send our hips back, maybe our heart relaxes inside the front leg, breathing in to our stretch. With our inhale, drawing our heart forward, option to hang out here, option to rest the elbows underneath the shoulders, pushing through the palms or forearms to lift the collarbone to find that strength in our shoulders. That knee can be up or down at any time, or if you want even flow, you can pull the back knee up and relax it down. If you want to add a little bit more hip flexor, stretch as you breathe. We can all rest the back knee and push the chin on the ground or the elbows on the ground. Take a moment to stretch through the front side body. And then we're going to let our palms come back underneath our shoulders if we've rested the elbows and do a little flowing movement through the thigh and the hip. Maybe the outer hip opens, maybe the inner thigh folds. Maybe we have a little bit more freedom than we did earlier in our Warrior Two stance when we're trying to get a little flowing movement in the hips. And then as we find stillness, this front leg, we're going to take the arm of the front thigh and have a few options. So first option is to slide the arm under the leg. And slide the arm forward. And slide the arm up or reach it back. The thigh, have the option to lengthen out the leg and stretch through the thigh and the hip. And wherever we're at, we're going to child's pose. Send the hips towards the heels. Let the body rest. Find a moment to breathe. Get a few resting exhales wherever the body's feeling peace. Continuing in our child's pose. Maybe we're flowing through plank or kneeling plank. Maybe we're hanging out or exhaling. Elbows in. Inhaling. Our heart open. Exhaling. Our hips back. Feeling a few relaxing breaths. If you like that three-legged dog option, we can send the left toes to the sky, our left heel to the hip opening through the front thigh, and then helping our left foot come wide outside the left hand. Again, back knee up or down, we're flowing the hips back and forth, drawing the heart forward, releasing the hips back, feeling that stretch through our breath. Maybe our hips lay back with our heart sinking inside the front thigh and breathe. Find a few relaxing breaths. tingling here or reaching forward, lengthening the spine with our palms underneath our shoulders or forearms, resting, pushing through the palms or forearms to find that length, pushing through the body and the head as we breathe. If we've got our leg lifted, we'll go ahead and rest the knee. We'll lengthen out the arms, creating that tall spine, and inhaling, pulling the heart as far forward as our bodies allow today as we breathe. Now with our spine tall, feel your outer hip opening, inner thigh folding, creating just a little stretch and release through the thigh, through the hip. And as we find a place of stillness, having some options for our arm, maybe the front arm reaches under the front thigh, or reaches forward, or reaches up, or reaches back. If we have the arm underneath, the front through the butt and the hip as we breathe. And then wherever we're at, maybe we're relaxing, or downward dog. Take a moment to relax wherever we're feeling good stretch. Enjoying stillness. Maybe we're inhaling, plank, or kneeling plank to stay. We can exhale, elbows in, inhale, the heart open, exhale, the hips back, and breathe. A little stretch through our breath. Then from our downward dog, if we like, we'll send our toes wide, maybe even opening the toes to the side. Option to stay in the downward dog or walk our hands towards the legs. Release. Option to have soft bent knees or straight legs, wherever our body feels the best stretch at the moment. Continuing here, sending the tailbone back, finding a little bit of a tall yoga squat or sinking our hips towards our heels, finding our small yoga squat, like our elbows pushing through the inner thighs, feeling the lungs reaching open as the spine grows tall and breathing. Stay in yoga squat. You can have lots of options. You cove, your firefly fan, have at it. It's kind of like adding those two thigh extending movements together. We're going to take just a moment to wiggle out our toes. So maybe even rock on our feet if you're in the yoga squat. Lift the heels, tuck through our thighs and our hips as we breathe. And then we can all find our way to mount, grounding the heels, inhaling fingertips towards the sky, relaxing the arms, feeling a little sway movement as we relax our shoulders, our ribs. And we'll find a place to work on balancing, feeling one heel ground, thigh engaged, knee joint softens. The other thigh can be forward or open, but squeeze in to stabilize, lift up to engage the core. So we ground our palms, our toes can stay, our toes can float, our foot can rest inside the calf or the inner thigh, choosing our space that is a pushing in our joints. Hands at the heart or resting, or reaching, finding stretch through our breath. Just a bit. Training sides, the other foot can feel the ground, the other thigh forward or open. Let's reach it in, lift it up, foot inside the calf or thigh, anywhere we're not pushing into our joints, palms grounded, or resting, or reaching anywhere, feeling pretty stable. chest this way, release our joints just a bit. The other foot to the floor, the other toe back. Arms drawn in the direction of our legs. As our front foot takes on the weight, maybe we float the back toe or bend the back knee or rest our hand and our foot together. Hanging out or inhaling, the heart opening, feeling that expansion through the front side body as we breathe. Relaxing that side down, rest our joints, let's straight sides. Sending the other foot forward, the other foot back, arms in the direction of right legs. Front foot takes on the weight as the back toe has the option to come up to the hand or anywhere in between. Squeezing through the inner thighs, maybe inhaling, heart, thigh open as we expand through the front side body, breathe. Letting the body rest, shaking out our joints. From the front of our mat, opening our lungs with our inhale, swan dive through the exhale. Reaching back to all fours or downward dog, feeling a stretch for our legs as we breathe. Option the three-legged dog or extend the right heel out. Helping our right knee reach up towards the wrist. Lengthening through the back leg. Maybe the inhale picks up the ribs. Expands through the front side body, staying open and lifted, or exhaling into any variation of a pigeon that our body agrees with today, finding a little bit of relaxation and rest as we release into our breath, feeling those exhales resting through our body. Letting that next inhale open up the front side body, stretching and expanding into the lungs, planting into our palms, grounding our back toes, pulling through the front toes and stretch the back where you feel good stretch. Great sides, option to extend through the left leg, helping the left knee find its way into pigeon. The back neck, knee can rest or we can lift up the lungs, stretching through the front side body to stay or rest, finding a moment to breathe, creating a few relaxing breaths, let our body relax through our exhales. Body lifting and opening the front, planting the palms, the back toes, and then the front foot back where you're feeling a good stretch today, breathe. If we're hanging out downward dog, our knees and hips can flow a bit side to side from all fours, shoulders and hips can fold together. And anytime we're ready, we can rest in child's pose, knees together or wide. Find a moment of relaxation. Maybe our arms stay stretching forward, or our hands rest under the forehead, or our fingertips stretch by our ankles, allowing the body to have a moment of rest, release through our breath. And our inhale, lifting up our ribs. Let our exhale, relax our tailbone to the ground. We'll stretch our legs out ahead of us and feel just this little flowing movement through our hips as we breathe. We'll slide one foot inside the thigh. Inhaling fingertips towards the sky. Exhaling heart towards the thigh. Let the ribs, the shoulders relax. Find a moment to breathe. A few resting exhales. Reaching up our spine, we'll scoop up this bent knee in our hands or the elbows, depending on how we're feeling today. Creating that tall spine, rocking our hips just a bit, side to side, we'll relax here through our breath. Stay with our cradle the baby movement. Our same hand as foot can hang out, our hand on the thigh. Feel that little pumping movement as we send the thigh towards the shoulder. Thigh extends out. Find a stretch and release. Get our breath. We're going to continue this movement or send the hand inside the leg and stretch the leg out to the side. Feel that length through the spine. Rest in the shoulders and breathe. We're sliding this top leg over the bottom leg. Inhale, reaching the spine tall, and then exhale, resting forward. Letting our bodies relax through our breath, just a few relaxing exhales. Sending our spine tall, shoulders resting, let's trade. So we'll let the other foot come in. Reaching our spine tall, exhale, rest forward wherever our body allows. Our best stretch today, breathe. Bring just a few relaxing breaths through the thighs, the hips, the shoulders, the ribs, the lower back. Reaching through the spine, maybe we're scooping up the hands onto the foot and the knee, or the elbows onto the foot and the knee. Picking up the ribs as we inhale. Find our rocking movement in our hips, whatever we're feeling the best about today. Breathe. And then from here, same hand to foot or thigh. Reaching the sole foot out. Spine grows tall. Let's have that little pumping movement through our thighs and our hips. We'll stretch through our breath. And again, we can stay here, hand inside foot, calf or thigh. We can stretch the leg to the side. Feel that length through the ribs, wherever our body gives us to stretch today. We're going to let this top leg hang out over the bottom leg. Spine lifting tall with our inhale. Maybe exhaling softly or deeper forward. Wherever we're feeling our best stretch today, let's rest into our breath. As we stretch our spine tall, unraveling the legs, rocking our legs just a bit side to side. And then finding maybe a little wider butterfly. Picking up the ribs, we're going to send the ribs towards one leg. Picking up the ribs, send the ribs towards the other leg. Feel just a little reach side to side. Ribs reaching towards one thigh, ribs reaching towards the other thigh. As we lift our spine tall, let's lengthen out our legs into a V, just as wide as our legs feel like stretching today. Maybe send our hands to our thighs and roll into our hips. With our palms resting the femurs, let's lift the ribs to the sky, sending the ribs towards one thigh, lifting tall, ribs towards the other thigh, lifting tall, feel that reach, side to side, and side movement. Depending on how we're feeling today, we can come to the middle and pick up the ribs and reach the ribs forward to stay, or have a few lifting and lowering movements. If we're staying, hands can rest in front of the chest, letting the body find a moment of release through the hips, lower back. Let your body find a place of stretch that works the best today. Breathe. We lift our ribs tall, sending our soles of the feet together, any variation of the butterfly, narrow or wide again. Picking up the lungs on the inhale to stay lifted. Maybe we hinge softly forward. Maybe we find a little bit more release as our heart draws towards the toes. Feeling a few resting breaths, wherever we're feeling our best stretch at the moment. The next inhale, pick up the lungs, our knees fold in as our feet find the front of our mat. Sending our ribs to the sky as we inhale, holding on or reaching out as we exhale, lower with as much control as our body allows. Shoulders resting, legs lengthening, arms can rest by the side or stretch over the head and create that reach through our body. And at any time, maybe bending the elbows to our shoulders, our ribs, and lower back, find a moment of peace, a moment of relaxation, and rest for our breath. As our arms ground by our side, into the lower back, and we'll feel that grounding through our spine. We're going to feel the right knee come in towards the shoulder, holding on to that right thigh wherever you're feeling the stretch, maybe further away from the body, maybe closer towards the body, and feel a little relaxation and rest with the right thigh and breathe. From here we can stay, knee bent, heel towards the hips, or we can push the sole of the foot up towards the sky. You can stay in stillness, or you can add a little bit of movement, opening the thigh out, squeezing the thigh back in. Feeling the grounding through the left side of the body, so we just try to open a little bit through the right side. Now again, we can stay with this bending movement. As our thigh reaches up to the side, maybe we push the leg towards straight. So you can bend the knee in the middle, and reach the leg towards straight to the side. Feel those outer hip thigh region kicking in to support that stretch as we breathe. And then we're returning the thigh to the chest, hug it in, relax out any extra sensations. And we'll trade. Send the left thigh in, lengthening up that right leg, feel that stretch here as we breathe. Again, staying with this movement or sending the sole of the foot up to the sky. Extend the stillness here, or move the outer hip open and your thigh back in, finding that reach and release here, activating the movement through the outer right hip, reminding this right side of the body to maintain grounding as we reach side to side. And if you reach to the side, you want to lengthen the leg towards straight, wherever space in our body allows. Take a moment to breathe. Pull it back in, hide that thigh back into the chest. Let both thighs come back into the chest and ground in stillness. Maybe rock a bit side to side and breathe. Maybe open up to happy baby with our hands finding the outer thighs or the feet. Maybe find a little stillness as we rock or rocking our spine side to side, wherever you're feeling a little release through the tailbone. The ribs, the shoulders. Again, you can stay with the rocking happy baby, or you can send hands to the thighs and maybe widen the knees out to this little upside down frog, and then feel the knees reach together, outer hips open, and our thighs fall. We can stay neutral to this upside down frog, or you can start reaching the legs out towards the straddle. Squeezing in, pressing out. Squeezing in, pressing out. So wherever body feels like taking us today. And as we come in, we're reaching into a butterfly. So thighs opening wide, hands stretching towards the shins or the feet. Feeling the hips getting heavy, the heels resting towards the hips and thighs, relaxing open. Feeling just a few restful breaths. Now we're going to stretch out those hip flexors and in our bridge pose, resting our heels in line with the knees, sending shoulder blades together as our fingers reach towards the heels. But inhale, push the thighs and hips up towards the sky. And feel this openness for a lot of anytime we're ready, relaxing the tailbone to the ground. As our arms find a little bit more wider stance, kicking the lower belly, stacking our knees over our hips, reaching knees and toes together. We'll begin to flow the knees side to side. Turn the ground through the shoulders as we feel that stretch through our thighs and relax through our breath. Stay flowing side to side. Maybe our knees feel like resting to one side, finding our gaze away from our bent knees as we feel the shoulders, the ribs, the lower back relaxing, feeling peace and rest through our breath. Finding neutral, let's send the thighs towards the other side, relaxing here for a moment, and breathe, fill shoulders, ribs, relax through the thighs and the hips as we rest through our exhales. Moving our knees back into our chest, releasing through the spine. Maybe enjoying just a little bit of rocking through our spine for a few breaths. Maybe sending our knees to the ceiling in a circling movement. Relaxing through the tailbone, lower back, the outer hips. We keep knees together, even send the hands to the knees and widening out our knees in our circling movements. Feeling a little extra stretch through the hip joints. Maybe trading out the direction of our circles wherever our body's allowing that release today and breathe. As our thighs come wide, we'll send the soles of the feet back into our butterfly, hands on the legs or the feet. So we feel that release through the thighs, the hips, relax in the tailbone and into our breath. Resting the pinky toes to the ground, we're finding a moment of stillness in our reclined butterfly as our thighs maintain their openness, our tailbone finds grounding, our shoulders relax, hands can rest inside, our thighs breathe. We can relax the arms and continue any relaxation pattern here. If you'd like to have maybe a little mini windshield wiper movement, we can Feel one knee flow up towards the sky, the other knee relax towards the side, and feel just a little rolling and releasing through our tailbone and the hips as we rest to our breath. So welcome to continue relaxation in our reclined butterfly. You can continue any variation of windshield wipering movements with the knees bent or sending the feet wide, find a little bit more space in the bigger windshield wipering movement. Or allowing the feet to be wide and the knees to rest together. Or taking a moment to stretch our legs out towards straight, feet opening, palms opening. Finding a moment to focus on our breathing. As our inhale travels in from the nose towards the belly, our exhale can rest back out of the belly, back out of the mouth. Feeling that deep inhalation. Feeling that deep exhalation. Allowing our bodies to find rest through our breath. Welcome to continue any relaxing breathing that feels at most stable for our body today. Maybe we think about the breath, having a small pause. So as we inhale, completely expanding the lungs and then pause. Exhaling, resting all the air back out of our lungs and then soft pause. Allowing that pause to create just a moment of peace in our body. A moment of stillness where everything is taking a break just for one small pause. Travel the breath into our fingers, our toes, welcoming any movements to our body at any time. Feeling relaxation as we breathe through our hands, through our feet. Relaxing through our wrists, through our ankles. Breathing through the lower legs, the lower arms. Relaxing through the knees, the elbows. Relaxing through the thighs, the hips. Feeling release through the upper arms, the shoulders. Feel the breath traveling through the spine, resting into our tailbone, relaxing the lower back, releasing through our rib cage. Relax the shoulders, the neck, the back of the head. Continuing as we are, or sliding our thighs towards the chest, finding a moment of stillness. And peace on the ground, or maybe a little rocking movement side to side. Finding any movement that our body is craving an extra release of today. Anytime we're welcome to stay on our spine and rest onto our side and feel the head rest in our hands or upper arms as we travel in some calming breaths through one side. Relaxing out anything we just don't need today through the other side. Allowing it to stay in the ground, making more space for that calm, peaceful breath to stay rest, peace through the rest of our day. At any time, we're welcome to find a comfortable position for ourselves, our seated option, legs, hips, choosing whatever works the best today. Let our tailbone relax, let our spine be tall, our shoulders rest. Kneeling, the palms opening, let's inhale and travel, fingertips to the sky. And exhale, rest the thumbs to the heart. Inhaling as we reach. Exhaling as we lower. Finding one more breath. Inhale, reaching tall. Exhale, resting down. Namaste. Thank you for joining me. Hi, Asta.